On Diesel Insights, we're going to take apart the 2.8-liter Duramax turbocharger and show you how it works. Today we're going to jump on the 2.8-liter Duramax. This is kind of a switching gears from our past videos over the past couple weeks about the LB7, LOY, LML turbocharger. We're going to go on the little guy today. And if you look at this thing, man, it is tiny. It's a 2.8-liter engine, makes about 180 horsepower from the factory. This is a Garrett turbocharger. For the record, it's called a GTB1752VKL. And it's called a 52 because on the compressor side, we have a discharge, a back wall of 52 millimeters. And that's gonna be there to support that 180 horsepower. The 2.8-liter Duramax has been a surprise winner for us. Almost right out of the gate, people started buying these things in droves and tuning them. It's turned into a performance truck. A turbocharger this small, we're gonna expect very quick spool up, good response, and good control at that power level. First thing I want to draw your attention to is how little this inlet is. It's a 35 millimeter inlet on the exhaust there. Downpipe, 47 millimeters. So already you can tell we're playing in the little leagues today, right? On the compressor side, there's a 37 mil inducer, 52 mil exducer. And on the turbine side, we got a 41 by 36. So pretty well matched turbine. On the turbine side, we have a variable geometry setup. It has vanes that are controlled by an external control module. So on the larger D-Maxes, that controller is integral to the turbocharger. On this one, it's external. It's got an actuator and a rod. And that rod will fit on here and actuate the vanes. I'm gonna give you a little better view over here. So here we have one that's been run hard. I'm gonna take off this cage around the vanes. Now this cage is made of Inconel, heavy piece. There's the turbine itself, and here's the vanes. And there's 11 of them. And they are controlled by the actuator via that rod. So when you're pulling away from a stoplight, you got the vanes close to 100%, right? They'll be about 85%. Under low load situations to give you that good throttle response, good takeoff. And as the load and RPM come up, as you start to stand on the throttle and the RPMs climb, you'll see the vanes open and increase the amount of turbine gas flow. Now, if you have the tow haul button actuated, you come to a stop and you use that grade braking, you use the compression braking, those vanes will close back up and create a high pressure situation in the exhaust manifold. And that's gonna give you that compression braking, that extra braking to save on your brakes. Kind of a neat setup. As far as modifying these guys, we've tried a couple larger compressor wheels. We've gone to a 41 mil compressor, which has netted us about an extra 35 horsepower so far. And then we have a 44 mil compressor, which you see on here right now. And that's quite a bit taller unit as well. So we're hoping for big things out of this one. Really, the limitation is this turbocharger has a very small exhaust side. And on the cover, there's not a whole lot of room for anti-surge. So, you know, as you start to go to those bigger compressor wheels, you're gonna lose the ability to control anti-surge or to control surge and to really, you know, keep drivability solid where it should be. Hope you enjoyed this episode of Diesel Insights. I'm Nick Priegnitz. If you like these videos and you wanna learn more, check out the Diesel Tuners blog, dieseltunersblog.com.